Hello, and welcome back to another episode with It's Dr. Dan, and today we're going to be learning about oxidation and reduction of carbohydrates, specifically simple sugars or monosaccharides. So with these, what we're going to be using is we're going to be looking at Fischer projections, which are when you take, let's say if you take a Haworth projection and you are to open it up, we're going to go through all the different reactions in a very simple to follow manner. We're going to go through all the different types of strong and weak oxidation, as well as reduction and enzyme oxidation as well. So let's take a look at what I have for you. Okay, the first thing is that all monosaccharides can be oxidized. So when that Haworth or that cyclic shape opens up and it unfolds, it is able to be oxidized. Now, you might be thinking back to organic, and you might be thinking that, well, can't only aldehydes oxidize? Well, one thing that can happen with these type of chemicals, with aldehydes and ketones, is that they can isomerize between the two, meaning they can rearrange themselves. So it's like taking a bunch of Legos and rebuilding a completely different shape. So the C double bond O can move from carbon number one to carbon number two as a result. So when it moves from one to the other, it makes this oxidation possible when it is an aldose, right? So aldoses can be oxidized. So we need this shape on the left, but this can happen naturally in your body through oxidation, through the proper channels, using enzymes. So like using an isomerase enzyme, they can be rearranged through metabolism. Let's take a look at the different types of reactions that we'll have. Okay, in front of us, we have D-galactose, which is a simple sugar or a monosaccharide. Now, the whole thing that we're going to be doing here is we're going to be first looking at how can this structure change and how can we identify it. Now, the first thing is it's all about naming, right? Naming an IUPAC is very important. So if we see that OSE ending in the name, that's telling you that you have a simple sugar. We can see that ending up here in the aldose before as well. Same thing when we learned about classifying them too. So if I were to put this through a reduction reaction, usually it's represented by a H because we're going to be adding hydrogen to it. So usually it's either represented with an H in brackets or maybe with H2 being added as well, one or the other. Because the idea behind these is the only thing changing is the functional groups. Now what sets an aldose apart is that it has an aldehyde at the very top of it. This is going to be changing. So how can that happen? Well, if you think of a double bond as a cabinet. Now, if I open up the doors of the cabinet, we're going to be adding hydrogen to that part of the double bond. So what I like to do is when we are to do these to help you remember oxidation reduction, is I always try to color code and change our different labels. So if I look at my double bond here, imagine the blue line as your cabinet, and we're going to open it. So what do I mean by that? Well, I'm going to open it where one door opens on the H, the other door opens on the C, and what are you going to be adding to both sides is a hydrogen, right? And now what did you make? Now we have a primary alcohol as a result. So that one prime alcohol is a product of reduction. Now, specifically, this is known as a sugar alcohol, okay? So it went from a simple sugar to a sugar alcohol, which has a name. This is known as an alditol, which has the ending itol. Now, how can I go through and name it? Well, before it was galactose, so we're going to keep the beginning part, and it's going to be galactol as the ending, right? We have the I-T-O-L ending as our change here. So let's color code that so it matches from above, and we'll do the same thing with our os as well. All right, so that's one. Now, what about if I want to go through the opposite way? What if I want to go through oxidation? What exactly can I do? Well, with this, we can go through weak oxidation and we can form aldonic acid, which in this case is if you go oxidation, we're adding oxygens. This is going to make a sugar acid instead. So sugar acid if you go one way, sugar alcohol if you go the other. Now, when we see this oxidation process, this is known as a weak oxidation, which is going to differ from strong. Weak oxidation, typically the way that you see that in a lab setting is if you're adding like Benedict's reagent, Tollens reagent. It's all about just changing a aldehyde to a carboxylic acid. So let's try that. So if I have the following, what the only thing that's going to be changing is the functional group, which is on top, and we're going to be adding an OH to it to help make that carboxylic acid all the way at the top. So see the C double bond O and the OH attached to it. So how would I change the name? Well, before it was galactose, so it's going to, we're going to keep the galact part, and then we will change the ending called to galactonic acid as the name, right? So just like so. So we have our sugar acid, and on the far left, we have the sugar alcohol, and in the middle, we just have a regular simple sugar. And that's the idea of oxidation reduction. Is this all that's possible in your body? Well, your body's a complex place. There's all kinds of other reactions that are possible too. Let's take a look at the last two and see what else is possible. Okay, the other oxidation reaction you can have is between weak and strong. And generally in organic and biochemistry, depending on what reagents are adding, you can specify the difference in how you are conducting an experiment. So if you have a strong oxidation, what this is going to do, it's going to oxidize two different points on your molecule. The first place it's going to oxidize is going to be the same idea as before. So usually we have oxidation, and typically we'll just call it strong. So the first one is going to match what we did on our last problem, where we add a carboxylic acid on the very top. Now, where else can it be oxidized? Well, think about where's the most vulnerable. Where is there maybe a primary alcohol that's ready to react? And that's going to be right down here at the bottom, right? There is a primary alcohol down here. So what can happen, just to kind of, and let's color code these just to show them, right? So we have the one on top. Now the one on the bottom can also go through oxidation as well. We can make a C double bond O, OH, because there's hydrogens ready to react. So you have two carboxylic acids or a dicarboxylic acid as a result. Okay. Now, when it comes to the naming, it's still going to follow a very similar idea as before. This is still a sugar acid, but this is going to have the aric ending all the way that we see up top. Okay. So if we kind of copy that down for ourselves, we're going to take the galactose part, so the galact, and it's going to be galactaric acid as a name. And being that this is D-galactaric acid, you're going to keep that letter for the sugar acids. And I should have did that on the last one as well. They're both D-galactaric and galactonic acid. Okay, so the ending changes to let you know how oxidized is it. Let's take a look at the last one in terms of how your body works with enzymes. The last type of oxidation there can be in terms of the metabolic processes for the basic of reactions is when an aldose reacts specifically with an enzyme. Remember, enzymes are specific. They choose exactly what they want to react with because these molecules fit and bind with them a very specific way. So one way that an enzyme can react with an aldose is that it can specifically select primary alcohols to oxidize. So if I have the same idea here where I have a reaction and I'm saying that, oh, this is an enzyme reaction, then how can I respect that particular reaction? Where can it react? So where is there a primary alcohol? So if we look closely, you got to try to remember, how do you pick primaries? Well, the whole idea is that you look at the alcohol, you look at the carbon next to it, and you see how many carbons is that bound to. If you look closely at the bottom here, right, so kind of put a little star here, that carbon is connected to only one other carbon, making it primary. So it's a candidate for an enzyme reaction. So what that means is the bottom alcohol here is going to rearrange itself to become a C double bond O with an OH. So we have another sugar acid that is going to form, but only on the bottom. The top is still an aldehyde. So just to kind of highlight that, right? Still an aldehyde. There's no change to the top. It only picks primary alcohol as where that reacts. So when that happens, this is going to have a very specific name. So being that that one on the left was D-galactose, the one on the right is going to be D-galacturonic acid. It sounds like something out of Star Wars. So it's going to be D-galacturonic acid is how we would name that structure. And that would be your final oxidation reduction on how you can understand and see all these different reactions. I hope that this video helped, and if it did, please hit that like and subscribe button, and I hope to see you around for future introductory organic and biochemistry videos. I hope you all have a wonderful day, and I'll see you all later. Bye now.